Yes, tithing still works. That's what I want to submit right now. Tithing still works, and a lot of people don't believe in tithing. And some of those arguments are so old, you don't have the energy to just wasting time, deliberating or debating with people over it. But again, some say it's Old Testament, but we know Abraham was before the covenant. Abraham was before the old law, the old covenant with Moses. So he was tithing before the law. And we know that, many of the money, much of the tithing was not bartering, but basically we were just giving. They would give up livestock, cattle. They give up their vegetables, corn and grain, and things of that sort, chickens and so forth, whatever they had to tithe, to the work of God. And the priest would live off of that, and that's how it worked. We understand the order there. But today, many of us are not farmers. We're not giving cows to the priest. We're not under that same old regime anymore. But still, the tithe works in that it's our money, our monetary gain. So when we take 10% of that and sow it toward the work of God into our local storehouses, God does do what he said he will do. Now, some who don't believe it never tried it. But you listen to a brother now who's been doing this for 33 years. It's 1983. I've never missed a tithe. And you'll go from 10%, where before that, you're trying to live off 100%, you can't even live off of it. And then you start doing 10%, you watch how God does the increase. He works it for you. And I'm telling you, whatever you blow a head gasket and all these things, and refrigerators go out, and washers and dryers and water heaters, and all these things, a lot of things fail on you. But God rebukes the devourer. When you start tithing, boy, your stuff start lasting. He preserves it. And then also he gives you the increases in pay and the promotions on the job. And when you have a business, he brings clientele to you. And then next thing you know, you're giving 15%. And you're giving 20%. And you find yourself living off like 78% of your income or 75%. Many believers today, after so many years, are tithing 25%. And they don't have to keep up with it anymore, with the numbers anymore. But at the end of the year, you realize you gave away 25% of your income and living off 75%. That's all due to the tithe. And nobody can argue with you when you know it works for you. Tithing still works. And then throughout the scriptures, all types of people say, well, it doesn't say it. And in the New Testament, you don't see the word anywhere, all that kind of stuff. Look, you just dig in there and research and look at the principles. And it's not even that God wants your money. Most people think God wants your money. He don't need your money. He wants your heart. Where a man's heart is where his money gonna be. And it's the tithing of the, I always like to specify, not even the tenth, it's the first tenth. As soon as you get paid, think about God. Break off what is God's first. So you get your house note, you got your car note, you got your cell phone bill, insurance bills, you got utilities, you got to buy food, you got to do this and that. So people categorize or they put in priority order what they need to pay for first. And see, if they gave God his first, the house note gets paid. The car note always gets paid. Your insurances always get paid when you give God his first, because he blesses that and he sanctifies it and makes sure the rest of it is done. That's why you give God the first orange off the harvest, the first tenth of oranges, and he makes sure the rest of your crop is sanctified. And that's Romans 8:29. If you want to just check it out, God who knew no sin. No, not that one there. Whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image and likeness of his son, that Jesus might be the firstborn amongst many brethren. So God gave up his first, and by him giving up his first, he sanctified the rest of us. So God wants our first. He wants to be first in our life. He doesn't want your money. He wants your heart. When your heart is into God, trust me, he got your back. He's got you covered. And you'll show it with your money, because where a man's heart is, where his treasure gonna be. Hallelujah. I just want to share that one with you. Click subscribe right now to bfabp.com. Then go to my site, anthonyblackmanministries.com, and check out some of the items available there. I'm just advancing the kingdom of God. And if you're going to be a subscriber, I pray for you on a daily basis. That's all this site is about, advancing the kingdom of God, trying to share tidbits with God's people. And if any of you ever feel like you want to sow a blessing, I'm telling you right now, we welcome that as well. Go to my site and make a donation. God might have moved upon your heart to do so. Say, this brother sure has been a blessing to me. And in my life, I'm going to sow into his cause. So anyway, that's what it's all about. Love you, care for you. In Jesus' name, amen.